Taxpayers actually paid for most of those changes at the stadium with a sales tax hike.
KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney is at the park right now to see if they're getting their money's worth. What do you think, Michael?
The early review is yes, especially according to a man that has a very distinctive view of this ballpark. He is not only a professional architect, but was not associated with this, but he is a Jackson County taxpayer.
Heading into the ballpark.
Architect Bill Barnhart is a devout baseball fan. See this? A souvenir from April 10th, 1973. He saw that game here, too, the first one in this ballpark, and he's back today.
This has a modern look to it.
As opposed to the retro style of a lot of new ballparks.
The ballparks like in St. Louis and, yes, those retro eclectic styles.
Watch his eyes now, his first glimpse inside.
This is very nice. It feels smaller. It does. It's more like a Fenway now.
Barnhart is most impressed by this, the ability to walk around the entire stadium. Of course, it takes a little longer than this, but you couldn't do that here before.
It reminds me a lot of what I saw at San Francisco Stadium last year, the walk around that goes all the way around the ballpark and encourages people to get up, walk around, and enjoy the stadium.
Now you can stand in right center field or sit in left center amidst the fountains.
I think it'll be pretty chilly. I'm not sure I'd want them on those nights, but once weather kicks in, I think I would like them a lot.
Behind home, premium, which means expensive, club seats.
They have to have this kind of seating and premium spaces set up for people. So yeah, I think it fits in fine.
Barnhart has discovered the new seat numbering system in the ballpark. Many more restaurants and different things to do here besides just watch baseball.
I saw enough games here when Ewan Kaufman was the owner to know that he was not a big fan of overdoing things, of advertisement. But I would have to think Ewan Kaufman would be pretty happy with what he's seen here today.